Welcome to another Get Your Geek On. I've not done one for a while. Comic-Con, maybe, was my last one? I can't remember. I don't do them enough. But this is a bit of a special one because I am off to London. London, baby! I might not keep that in. So, I'll explain all after the titles. So, yes, Get Your Geek On, people. Let's go to London. So, hello, welcome back. After the cool title was created by the Dandy Tiger, whose TV show I would love to develop one day. I'm on my way to London tonight. It's around sometime. I don't know what time it is, that's really bad. But it's not 6 o'clock and my flight is at 6:25. The Uber is on its way and I'm going to get in it and then we're going to go off to London. I'm going to meet Ed Parsons, aka Ecto Crank, who's a figurehead in the Ghostbusters community and one of our sponsors of EctoCon 2020, as well as one of our organisers as well. Ed has very kindly invited me to be his plus one for the screening of Cleanin Up The Town, which is a documentary about Ghostbusters 1. They originally made it as a two-part. Covering Ghostbusters 1 and 2. 2's been my favourite. And basically, the guys have been working on it for a long time now. And thankfully, I'm so sorry, I'm just burping. That's horrible. I just talk through burps now. Thank you, John Mulaney. So the guys have been working on the documentary for about 11 years now, and at last it is finished. So congratulations to everybody on the team of Cleanin Up The Town. So part one is being screened tomorrow at the BFI Max in London. So I'm off to London. I've not been to London since I was there with Anne Nicholson for MCM Comic Con when we were promoting Cops and Monsters Series 2, which we hope to finish at some point. That would be nice before I hit become an old man and everyone quits and everyone walks away. So yeah, super excited for London. Looking forward, although going to the airport, going to Stansted, then getting on a bus for an hour and a half, and then I'm going to Ed, so that's the beeping to say that my driver is arriving, so I will continue this at the airport. Glasgow Airport. There we are. Just at the taxi, the man was amazing. He was a really nice guy, really cool, really sophisticated, really intelligent. But now I'm going to rush to get through security and get on through the gate. So let's hopefully I make it on time. Security is empty. This is good. This means... That's weird. So this is good. Hopefully we'll get through quickly. Dum dum dum, the heat is on. I don't know how Barry does this. Hi Barry, the instructor. Check him out on YouTube. I don't know how Barry does it, filming himself when he's in public places, and I don't know what the score is when you're filming yourself at an airport, because I 100% filmed me walking through the security bit, and then as I left, there was a big like camera with a mark for it, going, so hopefully, I wasn't giving away too many secrets, but we'll see if the YouTube police take me down. So I am in Glasgow, I got through security, we're all good. I'm at Glasgow. I'm in Paisley, Glasgow International Airport in Paisley. And I am waiting for my flight to be announced. I'm going to Stansted, I'm meeting Ed. Going to Stansted, get on a bus to Ipswich for an hour and a half. So I'm going to be listening to my podcasts and my music and trying not to fall asleep and trying not to miss my stop. Let's find out what happens. So the reason I'm going to London, as I mentioned earlier, is because they're screening Cleanin Up The Town, which is by Anthony and Claire Bruno? I don't know, but I'll find out tomorrow, so there'll be a few corrections. These guys have been making this documentary for at least 10, 11 years, and they've been interviewing everybody and anybody involved in making Ghostbusters 1 and 2. As a Ghostbusters fan, this is a big deal. We've never had such a extensive look into the making of the movie, which would have been a real kicker for them, is that the guys who make the toys that made us on Netflix also did movies that made us, and they dropped an episode about Ghostbusters. 45 minutes, it's a semi-light and fluffy piece, but it was really good. I'm sure the guys at Cleanin Up Town aren't too bothered, because I'm sure their documentary is going to be its own thing, and I've no doubt in my mind that it's going to be fantastic. So I'm really excited. Not so excited about going to London. London's a bit of a sometimes good, sometimes bad. But I'm seeing Ed, and I'm really happy to see Ed. I've not seen Ed since, I don't think I've seen Ed since February at Capital. So at Capital Comic Con. So I'm really looking forward to seeing Ed. Hopefully meeting his wife Maria and spending some time with his little pug Jake. That's what I'm excited for. So I have arrived in London, in Stansted, more or less, and I worked my way through the terminals. That's where you're both. Worked my way through the terminals, and now I am at the bus coach station. Coach station, yes, it's behind me. There we go. So I'm waiting for the Ipswich bus, which will take me to Ed. It's so cold. Like, it's colder than Scotland. And as I phoned Ed to say, I'm here and it's cold. And he goes, that's something coming from a Scotsman. So yes, it's very cold. I'm very tempted to go get a Cornish pasty just to keep me warm, even though I've got a sandwich in my bag. But the Cornish pasty will be warmer. So I might go do that. And flight was fine. 45 minutes, an hour maybe, just a little bit longer. Just put my headphones on, put some music on and fell asleep, which was nice, and almost fell asleep on the lap of the woman next to me. Not on purpose, I just kept falling over. So yeah, not much more to this part of the adventure, of the journey. I'm here, I'm in Stansted. All good, my bus is in about an hour. The bus will take an hour and a half, so I look forward to like falling asleep. No, I'm not going to fall asleep because I'll end up missing my last stop and having to come all the way back here to Stansted, and I'm not ready to do that until Wednesday. Yeah, so much going on in my life right now. It's a bit mental, and some good and some not so good, and some great and some a bit meh. But I'm sure I'll get into that another time. Thank you for, I don't know how much of this will make it into the final cut when I sit down and edit this, depends what we do tomorrow. But yeah, this has been day one of the London trip. For the Cleaning Up The Town documentary. So yeah, all good. All good. Yeah, cool, awesome. I will see you guys soon. Okay, bye. Ed and I are in London for the Cleaning Up Town documentary.
And there's no one else here.
There's no one here. We're in Regent's Park.
There's four of us.
And look.
Four people in London.
It's eerie how quiet it is. Like, I feel like there's a memo that has been sent out.
We didn't get it.
That we didn't get it.
Don't
go to London today.
Yeah.
We got the train
in. Everyone's at the BFI.
Everybody.
Literally everyone in London's at the BFI.
Got the train. From Ipswich to here, and even that wasn't busy.
No.
And then
something's happening.
Then we got to Liverpool Street, and it was dead.
Yeah, and Liverpool Street is always rammed, like always.
Got on the subway to get here, dead. Just everything's eerily dead.
I've got London to myself. It's like 28 days later. Except neither of us are naked.
No, we're not. No, we're not. just a joke. That's right, Des, and you wanted those photos. but yeah, off to Hamleys to annoy people, so that'll be fun. And we'll take some hilarious photos. And this is just so weird, like, actually, properly.
There we go.
Welcome to Ed's Guide to
Waterloo.
To Waterloo. Yeah. Alright,
this is where they filmed Only Fools and Horses.
When?
Dates. The episode of Dates. He meets Raquel under the clock. Under the clock.
Thank you for that insight.
Gets accosted by multiple prostitutes, because back in the day, prostitutes hung out at Waterloo.
Is that true?
It is true, yeah. Not anymore, but there was a time.
And why are we here?
Why are we are here? None of your business, that's why we're here.
So Ed and I are trying to figure out how the fuck you get in. There's no... Just...
That way, it's so early.
Woo! Bit of a Dutch tilt.
Look, it's one of these on the other side.
Like, can we go in there?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we have to go on.
Because there's no other way, right? Oh, there's Cleanin' College.
I have never seen a building in the middle of a roundabout. Like, that's the last place for a building.
It's genuinely in
it's
the
almost,
middle.
It's almost genius in its execution. The entrance must be downstairs because it's not that obvious.
Oh, this is dope.
In Waterloo, I've clearly just ignored this building.
Well, this is how we die.
Disappearing into a London underground.
This is the end, my friend.
What was I dying to tell you?
Tell my wife I love her. Here we go. It's all outside, isn't it? Get me in there. Good night. Oh, man.
Here we go. Yeah, for me, who's definitely there. What is it?
So,
is it Star Wars?
Stormtrooper, right?
Yeah. I like the murdered out Stormtrooper and all that.
I'm slightly concerned about what's missing from his hand.
You know what to put.
He's pointing to something.
You know what to put in that hand. Come on.
Hot dog?
Hot dog, yeah, hot dog, of course. Of course a hot dog. What else?
It's quite intimidating. Oh look, so there's the Jumanji poster.
Mm-hmm. Ghostbusters trailer tonight.
I'm pretty sure Ghostbusters trailer will be a part of that, yeah. December 7th. So, Ed and I found the venue, but we're 3 hours early. So we decided to go for a romantic stroll.
Play Spot the Proton Pack.
We're playing Spot the Flight Suit and Spot the Proton Pack.
Listen out for the startup time.
Where? Found any yet?
There's so many lights, normally places aren't so well lit.
Because Ghostbuster fans only come out at night.
It's every time I see an LED, I think, right on pack.
So, yeah, we're just going to explore South Bank, and I've not been here for a while, so this will be fun. It's quite nice.
Oh no, so the bridge is here from there, in Parliament, so we might get taken down by some permits. It's probably the worst thing that'll happen tonight. It looks nice though.
It's beautiful.
I'm gonna go out with a view.
And this is where he drops his phone into the sea. Tell my wife I loved her.
I'm going.
It's cool that it's all kind of like under the bridge as well.
So when he knows if he chucks it down the road, we can enjoy it.
Welcome to London.
Smell. It's
alright, it's a genuine Christmas market, it's not just random. Yeah. Right, okay. Cool. Oh, look at this, this is gorgeous.
Someone admittedly earlier not really into Christmas, enjoyed the family's display in Waterloo Christmas Street, and now we're at a Christmas market.
I had reasons for that. I was going to say, well, it's not for a race.
Well, I left up your shirt, have you got a mistletoe belt buckle on?
Yes. Yes. For a race is alive and it's not half bad sometimes.
Yeah.
Hi, my name's Lee, and in my spare time, I sort of build and come up with some strange things that I take to events like Ghostbusters. And if you want to see more of my stuff, come along to the Ecto Con, which will be in 2020. And why should you come along? Well, there's going to be guests from the Ghostbusters franchise that you'll probably never get a chance to see before. And also, Ecto Con is the first European Ghostbusters convention. So if you haven't got your tickets, hurry up. They are going really quick. And hopefully, I will see you then. Next year.
Do you want one, Ed?
I'm having one. She's coming home with me. At least one for the wallpaper in my living room.
So, Ed, how long has this documentary been in the making for? A
couple of months. 12 years, I think.
And what are you most excited about finally?
Watching it.
Good, great. You give me all the great stuff.
Just watching it, to be honest.
You said to me earlier that you're just looking forward to more.
I want some more Harold Ramis. And some new Harold Ramis. When somebody dies, you don't then get new stuff from them. So to have 2.5 hour documentary filled with Harold Ramis, I'm in for that. I'm here for the Ramis.
So true story, and we'll explain this later.
It'll be in the documentary.
It'll be in our documentary. We got in. The movie's about to start, as you can see.
Look at that. It's beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful, we're all very excited. We almost didn't get in. Ed's furious. I've never seen a proper Tom Cruise moment before in real life. What happened? But we're in, we're very excited, can't wait for it to start. And here we go. See you in the episode.
Oh my god! Thank you so much for joining us for the European premiere. I can't believe 12 years in the making and we finally made it and you're here with us. Thank you.
And I guess it's just enjoy the film.
And after 12 years, it's...
It's up, it's Cleanin Up The Town.
Yeah. 48-hour trip to London is over, more or less. I'm now at Stansted Airport where my flight to go. And I'm so tired. Cleanin Up The Town, first of all, was an incredible documentary, so congratulations to Anthony and Claire. Literally 12 years in the making, and it was just so good. It was just, obviously they'd interviewed people who are sadly no longer with us anymore, including Harold Ramis, who was the co-writer of Ghostbusters 1 and 2 and played Egon Spengler in the films and the video game. So it's just nice to get more Harold, like Ed was saying. And it was just a really good, insightful documentary, how they made the film, how it all happened. It was just really good interviews, and I really liked how they animated some of the original artwork and some of the concept art and some of the old scripts and stuff that they were doing. It was just really nice to see, to be honest with you. So we left the screening at about 11. Ed and I and Tony, I want to say Tony, sorry if I got your name wrong, decided to have a wee cheeky drink in London before we went back to Ipswich with Ed. But every pub in London was closing around us, and London was just dead. It was really bizarre. So yeah, thank you to Ed for being an amazing host, an amazing friend, obviously. Had an incredible time. This has genuinely been the most relaxed trip to London so far. So it was really good. Can't really thank Ed enough for his hospitality, and Maria, obviously, for putting me up in a lovely home. Lovely to meet Jake the dog, and Jake the pug. Never have I seen a dog wear pyjamas before, so that was interesting. But yeah, it's been an incredible time. But it'll be good to get home, obviously. It's always good to go home. And that's it, really. Not much more to add to this vlog. I've no idea how long it's going to be or what's going to happen. I don't know if I'm going to split it to two parts or just try and keep it to 10-15 minutes. I don't know. But do check out Cleanin Up The Town. I believe it will be streaming and available to buy from next month, which will be January. And also, it's day 4 of Whamageddon and I'm still in. Last year I went out on day 1. So it's quite nice. Day 4, still in. I'll take it. If I can stay in an airport with Christmas music playing and still be in Whamageddon by the time I get home, I'll be happy. So yeah, thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. Don't forget to like and subscribe and all that jazz. Share the video if you are at all interested. If you think other people might be interested in watching this geek travel through London, all the way to London. As Ed puts it, all the way to London for 48 hours to watch a movie documentary at a roundabout. That was epic. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. And I'll see you on the next video, whatever that might be. Okay, bye-bye.